President Trump today hinted he'll declare a national emergency at Tuesday's State of the Union address, which wouldn't really be an emergency, to build a wall, which might not really be a wall, which he now says is already being built. Does that make sense? That's right. You heard right. After 2 years in office and a 35-day government shutdown, the president says he might declare an emergency to make something happen that he says is already happening. The president today said that construction on the wall or the barrier fence, whatever you want to call it, but he's now back to calling it a wall. He says it's already underway, that it's already going up.
Well, we're building a wall now.
Building a wall now. Now, as you might imagine, his claim took people in the room by surprise, so he elaborated.
Yeah, we're building the wall. People don't understand that. They're starting to learn. We're spending a lot of money that we have on hand. It's like in a business, but we have money on hand and we're building. I would say we will have 115 miles of wall, maybe a little bit more than that very shortly. It's being built. Some of it's already been completed.
Not only completed, he says, but prettier, too.
We've designed a much better looking wall that is also actually a better wall, which is an interesting combination. It's far more beautiful and it's better. It's much more protective, but it looks better because the walls that they used to build were not very attractive. I actually think that's possibly part of the problem.
So, I mean, just keeping them honest, none of that is true. That whole thing he just said. Last year in March, Congress appropriated $1.6 billion for border security, which has been used so far to rebuild existing barrier fencing, which, as you know, the president once had nothing but scorn for. And I'm quoting now from a campaign tweet. Jeb Bush just talked about my border proposal to build a fence. It's not a fence, Jeb. It's a wall, and there's a big difference. More recently, though, he changed his mind, saying you can call the wall anything you want, even peaches, he said. But then more recently still, just yesterday, he changed his mind yet again, tweeting, let's just call them walls from now on and stop playing political games. A wall is a wall. Okay, walls. Last year in San Diego, the president did look at these prototypes for different kinds of walls. But keep it honest, nothing that looks anything like this is under construction, let alone finished. No new miles of walls, period. Only bollard fencing, and none is better or prettier in any way or different, as the president suggests, from what came before, because the bill that he signed last year specifically says it can't be. And I'm quoting now, there's the legislation, quote, the amounts designated in subsection A2 through A4 shall only be available for operationally effective designs deployed as of the date of the Consolidated Appropriations Act to 2017 Public Law 115-31, such as currently deployed steel bollard designs. In other words, not new and not better looking, whatever that means. What's more, the false claims he made today, they aren't even new. He's been making them at rallies as well as official appearances now for nearly a year. 2 months ago, he said he just awarded a contract for 115 miles of wall. He hadn't. Today, he said he was using cash on hand to fund the wall. Broadly speaking, only Congress can appropriate money and authorize spending. What the president seems to be doing now is reimagining stuff that isn't really what he wanted as something that he's actually wanted all along, which is fine if you, say, wanted a pony for Christmas, you got a hobby horse instead. Make-believe is fine when you're a kid or a real estate developer in New York with no shame. But it's different, or at least it should be, when you are president, when you are threatening to take emergency measures to get what you want, and when you're twisting the facts to make that case. More now, the whole range of issues surrounding the border and the showdown over it. I spoke earlier this evening with Congressman Michael Waltz, a Republican in Florida. Congressman Waltz, President Trump saying that he should change his chant from build the wall to finish the wall. How can he finish a wall that he hasn't even... I mean, it hasn't been started yet.
Yeah, well, look, you know, at the same time, he's also said a lot, including a speech from the White House last week about wall, barrier, steel slats, fence, call it what you want to call it, but we need to secure the border, and physical barrier is part of that, and that has been started. Members of both sides of the aisle have voted, including the Secure Fences Act in 2006, for a barrier as part of overall border security for years. So finish it, complete it. My position is let's let the current committee that is negotiating that finish its work, come to a compromise, keep the government open, and let's move on to a lot of other business that the country needs.
But, I mean, the president portraying it as, finishing it, basically he's trying to pretend that his wall, the wall that he campaigned on, the one that he said Mexico would pay for, has already started to be built, when in fact it's just updating the fencing that, as you said, has existed, has been voted on in the past. There is no new wall of the president's that's begun.
Well, but I think he's also making the point that, that barriers that secure our borders are also not immoral. And so when Speaker Pelosi says that I'm not going to give you a dollar now and I'm not going to give you a dollar ever, particularly when she has said I'm not going to negotiate until the government's open, now the president has moved and reopened the government and then now is saying we're still not going to negotiate. I think he's making that point as well.
But you acknowledge when the president says finish the wall, he has not started. No Trump wall has begun. There's only just been updates,
I think what I'm trying to say, we could spend the rest hour, the next hour going round and round about the definition of wall. I think this has been kind of, frankly, somewhat of a silly rhetorical exercise. Fence, slats, barriers, whatever, we have started it. We've voted for it repeatedly in the past. Let's finish it and complete it, secure the border, and move on to important reforms.
Do you think the president should declare a national emergency? Because clearly that seems to be the way what the president is hinting that he might declare one. And if it is a national emergency, why wait to declare one? Why not do it now?
Well, I think we need to let these negotiations continue, and I hope we do. Like I said, compromise can't be a dirty word. We have both sides sitting down to work this out. And that's what I hope continues. That's what I want to see continue. And what I want to see, them come to an agreement before February 15th.
So just for a compromise, and in terms of a compromise you would support, if Democrats said, OK, look, there will be more bollard fencing. There'll be another 10 miles in this area because it's a strategic area. We think this will help. There'll be some steel slats over here, but we're not going to call it a wall. Is that to you? Is that fine as long as there's other things as well for border security, manpower, technology?
I think that's completely reasonable. That's in line with what we've done in the past.
Congressman Walz, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, Anderson.
All right. So there's new reporting tonight in the Washington Post. Two Republicans telling the paper that Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell warned the president this week not to declare an emergency. Leader McConnell telling the president that if he did, Congress might end up passing a resolution disapproving it, which is forcing the president to contemplate for the first time vetoing legislation in the face of opposition from his own party. More now on where this leaves the president and the country. Joining us is Axe Files host and former senior Obama advisor David Axelrod, also CNN senior political analyst David Gergen, who's, of course, been in the West Wing trenches for Democratic and Republican presidents, going all the way back to Richard Nixon. So, David Gergen, do you have any faith that the president will actually listen to Mitch McConnell on this?
Not much. And I don't think Mitch McConnell has much faith either, but he's trying to do the best he can to prevent another disaster, a political disaster for the president and for the Republican Party. It's the party that's increasingly in danger here. Back in September, Gallup had a favorability of the Republican Party at 45%, Democrats 45%. Now Democrats are still at 45, but the Republicans are down to 38, 37. So it's a they're feeling the heat in Mitch McConnell's party. I think the president is simply confusing the issue, and he's painting himself, surprisingly, he just painted himself into a corner with Nancy Pelosi, a few weeks ago, and now he's painting himself into a new corner. He's either going to he's going to do this national emergency or he's going to get a wall, and he's not going to get, I don't think either one is palatable to his fellow Republicans.
David Axelrod, I mean, could it be a turning point in terms of Republican support for the wall if the president does declare a national emergency to build the wall?
Look, the president is in a jam, and the Republicans are in a jam. Off of what David said, I don't know that the president's really much worried about the status of the Republican Party. The president's worried about his own reelection, and he's being told by his allies on the right that if he doesn't do something dramatic to promote the wall, that he will face a rebellion within his own party, and that's what he's worried about. And so I think that the declaration of a national emergency, he knows, I'm sure he's been told, this will immediately go to the courts. It will be held up in the courts and very likely thrown out by the courts as unconstitutional. But at least he'll have looked like he was defiant in defense of the wall, and I think that's what he's being told. There are a lot of Republicans who think that this would be an abuse of executive authority and are very much opposed to it. But I think he's looking for a way out of this that doesn't make him look weak.